Yo guys, welcome back to the channel. So now we'll be focusing on the user view side. So you can just go ahead and clone this repo which I have put in this branch, and I'll be updating it further on in this master branch. And you can just give me some contribution, like by forking it and just giving it a pull request, and I'll much be obliged. So let's continue. So this one is my user view branch, and this one is my HTTP API setup branch, and I'll be following this app components, images, and here will be our server working.png which we have finished, and this will be our main flowchart. I know it's quite long and I want you to follow this guide. So as it shows, it will choose a platform, and then it will choose either this icon icons and then custom icons, and then switch to the default switch to camera, which in default is front, and then it will check for camera front, and if it is true then it will switch to front, otherwise it will switch to back. And as we will be focusing on this first launch, I will be navigating to here and then check for this. So let me just build it in white. So we have just put up such changes in boiler.js, like we have put up this platform and device emitter and model. So let me just show you in this main boiler.js. So in here we have just imported this, and then we just created this create icon set from React Native Vector Icons. You can follow my previous guide, that would be that second lecture, or you can follow that update and manual.md and also that code.txt. So for platform iOS, we have just created icon set as icon and icon set as custom, where bitmap is just nothing but the speaker, mic mute, keypad, send mute, phone, hang up and flip camera, which will be which I will be showing you later on. And then we have set this camera as default as front, and then this is mode open and status idle, and then this VoxImplant is calling this switch to camera camera, where if the camera is front, that is in default it is front, so it will be switched to back, otherwise it will switch to front. And now we will be going to this render for view and text, which will then go into the six files, which will be video panel, calling text, number input, button, keypad, and settings table, and it will be invoked only when this particular status will be invoked. So as it is going to this idle state at first, I'll show you it. Now I have just put up this view where I'll just be showing this logged in, and then I have invoked this six files which I have defined it here, and it will be rendered only if in this particular case, which in first we will be working on this idle case, the status is idle, and this model will be showing us when we are not the caller but we are the receiver, and it will show us either receive call or reject call. So in this video I will only be focusing in idle case, and in idle case it will be this number input will be invoked, where text input for entering caller ID will be shown, and on change text this will be invoked, and when submit button is clicked, then it will go into this make call option, and it will just go into this STK create call and check for the caller ID, and if it is true then status will be changed to calling. And then we have also to show this button, because this button will be the main option to click and then to move into this make call, and will also be showing us this further option to this settings table, where it will give option to either go into this peer-to-peer case or in conference call and choose this video option or not. And then we'll navigate to caller switch and we'll just change the caller of the button if it is invoked. So for number input, we have defined this bar number, and then And component head mount, we have named that this number to be focused on. And then this will be invoked only in the case that we have updated this file. So let me just show you. So for number input, we will be going to this text input if status is idle, and on change text you will update number, and on submit, that is if you press enter, it will go into on submit. And we have defined this number and this component mount will focus on this underscore this number, and then on update number, the number will take the text, and this number will set the native props of text. And on submit, that is if you press enter, this dot make call will invoke, and we are here to define this make call, which will be going to the STK voximplant. Now we have put up this current call ID, which will take this call ID and the number, and then settings P2P and settings video, which will be defining either for P2P or in video just later. And then we'll list add listener for device event emitter and call reading, call ringing. If you don't get it, I would advise you to follow my previous video. And then we have defined this make call, which will be coming back later. And we have just put up this button if status is idle, where it will show icon dot button, and where this on press will go into this dot make call. So let's check it. So on this dot make call, it will go into make call, which will console log the number, which is right here. And then settings VTU will be defined later, and function call ID, which will be fetched from this device event emitter. And then it will, if the settings underscore P2P is true, which isn't in default as it is defined as false, it will go into this else condition, where it will start call with call ID and set state of status as calling. Now I have put up this settings table, where we'll be showing for this peer-to-peer and video, which will be defined in this caller switch, which I'm yet to define, and I'll define it just later, where this will take settings to settings under P2P for the value if it is changed, and on the value change, it will go into this video switch, where settings underscore video value, which will be taking it in this make call also, and it is to be defined here, which I'll do it now. So I was getting some small error because I haven't installed this update, so just go ahead and update and just go and import this caller dot switch, and don't forget to import this create icon set and follow their own guide, or follow my previous guide. And let me just check if there's anything missing. So I've just imported them, and I'm yet to be defining here, which I'll be doing it just later on. So let's check in this caller.switch. So we have defined this for both Android and iOS, as it has different switch for Android and then for iOS. So in caller, so it is doing nothing but just giving me either if it is pressed or not, and just changing on tint color and tint color in this switch, and update the value. So in case of any further error, just do install this button, the React Native button, and I'd advise you to check if you have similar dependencies as to mine, where I've imported this update button, vector icons, and box implant. Spinner will be used for my previous video, where I've used it in login and register. And don't forget to give your stylings. So we have just missed a small thing, where we just defined this settings underscore view, but haven't used it. So I just went ahead and is in this render, when settings under video is set as true, that is color switch is clicked and it's set as true, the then we need to show this video panel, which will be showing this remote view and preview, or remote view and self view, where remote view will show you this crisper video and self will show you this colored user's video. All this process has been done. So I'll see you in the next video.